الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Like we promised last week, we will, inshallah, embark on explaining Surah An-Nur, not of course verse by verse, but what the scholars of tafsir call it, التفسير الموضوعي, the subjective kind of explanation of the verses. يعني every block of verses they normally have a subject which they address. And this surah is very important because it addresses the family and how our homes should function. And it is very important to teach it, especially to our wives and our daughters. ورد بالفعل أن عمر يعني sent a message to one of the leaders, رضي الله عن عمر, of his province, الكوفة, I believe, where he actually requested, علموا نساءكم سورة النور. Teach your women سورة النور, because it governs the home, how a person should enter and so forth. Today, inshallah, I just want to introduce the subject of the surah, because you know that the way the you enter into Surah An-Nur, right away the first verse, flogging and do this in public and so the first verse, the second verse actually, Surah أنزلناها وفرضناها وأنزلنا فيها آيات بينات لعلكم تذكرون. Look at this immediately. الزانية والزاني فاجلدوا كل واحد منهما مئة جلد. ف we really have to يعني level up here and understand why, what is the wisdom. They say, يا إخوة, جميع النصوص القرآن والسنة, جميع نصوص الوحي, all the revelation are geared, and this is something that you heard me saying before and I repeat it again, and I hopefully you can understand it, because America has a big misconception about the word Sharia. It scares them. But look at this. All the revelation, the Quran and Sunnah, are geared towards five goals, five objectives. Oh, the Sharia, this Sharia, the word, which non-Muslims are afraid of because they don't understand it, has maqasid, has aims, objectives. They say five. The protection of tawheed, the protection of ibadah, the protection of worship, the protection of the deen. Two, the protection of the life, the soul. حفظ النفس, حفظ الدين, حفظ النفس. Three, the protection of, I guess the word is progeny, is that right? Progeny, right? عرض, that is the right word. عرض, progeny, and I'll explain that. And this is the subject, so we're going to have to leave this one alone because this is the subject of Surah An-Nur. حفظ العرض, the protection of progeny. Adultery is a threat to progeny. And that is why Surah An-Nur is serving. It serves that objective. Four, the protection of the rational, intellect, العقل, to protect the human عقل. Five, the protection of the wealth, حفظ المال, the individual property. That is your money. Nobody is entitled to take away from it. You will find that a lot of text, a lot of divine text, a lot of revelation is geared towards achieving these aims. Let's begin, for example, with يعني التوحيد مثلا, الدين, حفظ الدين. طيب, how do you justify that one day a man, a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, says to him, إن شاء الله وشئت, if Allah wills and you. Anybody would hear this now as if nothing happened, that statement. Look at the reaction of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أجعلتني لله ندا, are you making me a rival with Allah? Because the translation for this, and maybe some of you do not grasp the mistake here, and which is wa in Arabic makes al-ma'tuf wal whatever came before it and whatever came after it equal. And in the Arabic language, places whatever came before it, whatever came after it, equal in everything. I say Ahmad wa Muhammad, that means they are equal. Now, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is telling the companion, are you making me equal with Allah once it comes to the will? Is the will of the created equal to the will of the Creator, ya ikhwa? La, impossible. Rather say, you should say what? قل, say, إن شاء الله ثم شئت. If Allah wills, then you will. This way you placed the will of the messenger under what? After. When I say what? Ahmad wa Muhammad entered the masjid. This means both of them entered at the same time. But I say Ahmad entered then Muhammad. So who came next? Who came after? Muhammad. After what? The same exact thing. So right away, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the interesting piece here that I just want to, now we're talking about the protection of the deen. Protecting the deen. The violation in the religion begins with a sentence, with a word. في كلمة الآن يا إخوة المصريين ما يستطيع أن يتركها. The Egyptians in particular, كلمة والنبي. تسمعوا كده أي حاجة يقول لك والنبي 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 على طول. ليه؟ لأن it was what? When he said it the first time, nobody said to him what? Stop. He kept saying it until it became what? Built in, encrypted inside his system. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is trying to stop this from the get-go. No. وأنا أقول لك ما خطر على بال الصحابي رضي الله عنه أنه يعني يشرك بالله النبي. يعني أنا أقول لك هذا الصحابي, this companion, I don't think he even thought about this. He did not mean to place the messenger equal with Allah. بس يقول لك إيه, الإسلام, our religion, came to straighten the inner side, which is the heart, and اللسان. الدين, our religion, يا إخوة, ديننا جاء لكي يقيم القلب ويقيم اللسان. That your tongue and your heart are straight up. Again, this is in a way, وجناب يعني التوحيد يا إخوة, لأن listen, this universe, this world, this life, you and me were created for this. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. That is why the books were brought down. That is why messengers were sent. That is why there will be a day of resurrection. That is why there will be Jannah. There will be Nar. Because of this. Because of the deen. The protection of the deen in Islam is a key. What is the wisdom? A lot of the people may not reflect upon this. What is the wisdom that you're not supposed to pray in a masjid where there is a grave? What is the wisdom? It's not that. You may get the feeling that when you're praying, that you're praying to that person underneath the ground. Shirk. إنك تشرك بالله هذا إبعد. This is يا إخوة, this is what we call in Islam what? سد الذريعة. في حاجة في الدين اسمها سد الذريعة. You block the way. You block the way that leads to it. You begin with what? How the people started worshiping the graves? How the whole thing started? How? He goes and he prays. He prays to Allah the first time. But then gradually, people may think, oh, he's praying to that dead person down there. And this is how shirk started within the people of Nuh. A lot of the brothers, a lot of the sisters do not understand why our Sharia bans us from having pictures, from having idols, from having drawing of humans. A lot of us don't understand how shirk started to begin with. If you realize how shirk started in earth, you will understand why. Our Sharia said, block the way to this. What happened to the people of Nuh? يقول ابن عباس, عبدالله ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما في تفسير قوله تعالى وقالوا لا تذرن آلهتكم ولا تذرن ودا ولا سواعا ولا يغوث ويعوق ونسرا كما عند البخاري. يقول لك ايه, 10 centuries. How many 10 centuries? How many years? 1,000 years from Adam until Nuh, and the people are in Tawheed. ما في شرك خالص, no shirk in earth. What happened? 5 righteous people, what we would call in Christianity saints, يعني very righteous, أولياء يعني, معروفين, they are known of their righteousness and piety. ودا سواع يغوث يعوق نسر, 5 رجال صالحين. They used to live amongst the people of Nuh. They passed away. They passed away. The people missed them. يعني they missed them being there. They started making shapes of them. And they started placing it in the house. Imagine when you look at the figure of that person in the house, and guess who's watching? Guess who's watching? When you hang a picture of your father, for example, in the wall out there, and you, يا سلام يا أبويا, حشني يا أبو. Your child is watching you. He's going to do the same and more. The next, you see that the impact may not happen right away. That's what I'm trying to. Actually, it took them 300 years to finally place these idols in a temple and start worshiping and offering them qurbani and وشوف يجي نوح عليه السلام. Nuh spending 950 years for them to leave this. ما هو بقول لك ايه, اي شيء يا اخوه, anything which turns any bid'ah which turns into a sunnah because of 2 reasons. سكوت اهل العلم, a student of knowledge sees it and he doesn't speak about it. لا أسمع لا أرى لا أتكلم. I do not see, I do not hear, I do not speak. Why? Because he gets in trouble. 2, القدم. That it people keep doing it over and over for 100 of years. until it becomes what? Part of their culture, part of the society. You cannot, يعني to remove this as if you remove a mountain from one place to another. And this is what they call sunnatul aba. The sunnah, the way of the fathers. And the way of the fathers is the first thing which encountered all the messengers. شوف رسول الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling the messenger, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ فِي قَرْيَةٍ مِنْ نَذِيرٍ إِلَّا قَالَ مُتْرَفُوهَا إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَى أُمَّةٍ على نظام يعني أمة على نظام على سيستم وَإِنَّا عَلَى آثَارِهِمْ مُقْتَدُونَ شوف يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم We have not sent a messenger before you but the people told him the following Listen, we have found our fathers doing this and we're not going to leave it. اعمل اللي انت عايزه. Blocking the way, because if it becomes established, it leads to something else. يعني I don't want to, because I want to get into the piece which deals with Surah An-Nur, which is حفظ الأرض. بس you understand يا إخوة حفظ مقام التوحيد حفظ الدين وحفظ الدين يا إخوة the religion is the most important thing in your lives ولذلك يقول لك الرجل ساعة الفتنة أمان at the time of fitna will be carrying his deen in his hand like he's carrying a piece of fire and he grabbing fire in his hand deen يقول لك غريب you're a stranger أهو ويقول لك you pass by the grave of another person you wish to be in his place why because you want to guard what you want to protect what your deen from the fitna because too much fitness and you want to protect your deen your religion your tawheed so you want to die as a Muslim because this is the success so a lot of the divine text Quran and Sunnah are tuned towards التوحيد towards protection of your religion and you should apply those حفظ النفس حفظ النفس the second objective of the sharia is the protection of the nafs يا إخوة the soul which you have inside your body the one who placed it is Allah no one is entitled to take it out but the messenger of Allah which is the angel of death extracted from the body even so it's your soul but if you do it yourself you get punished in the grave until the day of resurrection Allah knows best if you're going to stay in hell for eternity or what matruk lillah yani If you commit suicide, if you try to kill yourself, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Man qatala nafsahu bihadida, whoever strike himself with a piece of iron to kill himself, he keeps doing this in the grave until the day of resurrection. And Allah knows best, he's waqa tahti al-mashi'ah. He's under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-hadith yaqul khalidan mukhalladan fi an-nar. Walakin nafham hadhihi nusus, He's under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever poison himself, he will keep doing this in the grave, and Allah knows best, maybe in hellfire for eternity, or maybe Allah will take him out. He's under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throw himself from the top of a mountain. Again, you may think that this is your nafs. Wallahi, ikhwa, last night, a sister calls me. Look at this question now. Sheikh, give me permission to kill myself. Wallahi, هذا السؤال. شوف الجنون. Permission from me to kill yourself? You need that permission from Allah, يا أختي. Wallahi, هذا الكلام قلت له. You need that permission from Allah. If Allah can give you that permission, go ahead. But see me? I didn't place the nafs in your body. I have nothing to do with it. And I told her what I just told you. I thought, if you do this, why? I'm depressed. Go see a psychotherapist, يا أختي. Sometimes the issue is not just, sometimes people have problem in their brains and they they need some help to produce some chemicals or something, just go see a doctor. But don't do this. And who on earth can give you permission to kill yourself? You can't do that. الله المستعان. فحفظ النفس. ولذلك يا إخوة والله أنت تعجب، أول ديوان من دواوين المظالم يوم القيامة. You see, there is a list of injustices. Top of the line. Of course, الشرك that deals with the first one which we addressed. إن الشركة لظلم عظيم. But the second, والذين لا يدعون في وصف عباد الرحمن, in describing the servants of الرحمن, والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر, to, ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق. The first record of injustice, أول ديوان من دواوين المظالم يوم القيامة, ديوان الدم, القتل. يفتح. Bloodshed, killing first. Let's get those who killed and those who were killed. ويقول ابن عباس, يأتي المقتول. The person who was killed will come, يحمل رأسه على يديه, carrying his head on his hand. I don't know how he's doing it. يعني his head is on his hand. وتشغب أوداجه دما. His veins, the veins of his neck are pouring blood. ويجر قاتله. And he's grabbing his killer. ويروح قدام ربنا كده, يا رب سل هذا فيما قتلني. Ask him why he killed me. He deprived me from life. Oh. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني يقول لك إيه, لا يزال المؤمن في فسحة من دينه. حديث ابن عمر عند البخاري, ما لم يصب دما حراما. Your chances, your stakes to get to Jannah are high. Your chances for forgiveness are high as long as you do not kill somebody. ليه؟ لأن في كلام, يعني I just want to let you know, هذا رأي ابن عباس, إن القاتل ليس له توبة. وطبعا الكلام ده يرد علي, يعني الكلام هذا في نظر, يعني حديث قاتل المائة مثلا, يعني تاب الله عليه, يعني they say that the killer has no chance for repentance. يقول في كلام. وشوف أعظم عقوبة, لا تجد عقوبة, the greatest punishment mentioned in one verse, عقوبة القتل. شوف, ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا, whosoever kills somebody intentionally, شوف, فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها, وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما. Five punishment in one verse. Whosoever kills a believer intentionally, his abode is Jahannam for eternity. Allah is angry with him. The curse of Allah is upon him, and he has prepared for him a painful punishment in the day of resurrection. هو ليه انت تعجب من عمر؟ يعني عمر, when he was stabbed في المنبر, عمر بن الخطاب, when he was killed by أبو لؤلؤة, when he was bleeding, he called أبو ابن عباس, قال يا ابن عباس انظر من قتلني, find out who killed me. شوف, عشان تعرف ان فابن عباس went out and he found out the killer is a مجوسي, اللي هو أبو لؤلؤة, عليه من الله ما يستحق. يعني somebody who is not a Muslim, someone who was brought to Medina because he has a lot of skills, and يعني سيدنا عمر wanted him to teach the Muslims these skills, فهي brought him to Medina to work, and he came from Persia, Majusi, he used to be worshipping of fire. فسيدنا عمر, سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما, came down to عمر, قال له غلام المغيرة. المغيرة بن شعبة was the one, رضي الله عنه, is the one who brought him, the one who's working for المغيرة. قال الصنع. He said the skilled one. شوف, look at the statement. Look what عمر said. الحمد لله الذي لم يجعل ميتتي بيد رجل يدعي الإسلام. وفي رواية سجد لله سجدة واحدة. All praise be to Allah that he did not cause my death at the hand of somebody who claims to be a Muslim. Why? Because he's going to end up being punished. Umar doesn't want to be shaheed at the expense of what? شوف تمني السلامة للمسلم يا إخوة. شوف, look at the يعني high level that you don't want your martyrdom to be at the expense of another Muslim going to Jahannam for eternity and the curse of Allah is upon him, the anger of Allah is upon him. And why? لا, someone else who did not prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one time. فحفظ النفس is the second aim, the second objective. المال comes in number three. المال, wealth. يعني we're leaving the progeny because it's the subject of Surah An-Nur. المال, الملكية يا إخوة, الفرضية. No one is allowed to take anything away unjustly. يعني في حديث البعض, يعني we read it sometimes but we don't pay attention to it. زيد بن خالد الجهني, الحديث الصحيحين, رجل أمان came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم وسأل عن ضالة الغنم. He asked about a sheep that is lost. يعني imagine a sheep run away from a shepherd and got lost. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, هي لك أو لأخيك أو للذئب. يعني if you find a lost sheep, it can be for you, it can be for your brother, or for the wolf. Imagine now we're living in a desert here. We're talking about a desert, not in Denver. طيب, يعني what is he trying to tell him? Find the owner. Who is the owner? Look for him. Try to find somebody lost the sheep. يعني look. If you don't find it, if you don't find him, then it's yours. Otherwise, who's going to have it? If you leave it out there, the wolf. Then, ثم سئل عن ضالة الإبل. And then he was asked about a lost camel. فغضب النبي. He became upset. وما لك وبها. What do you need from this one? A camel can stay in the desert for months. يعني they say 15 days without the need to eat or drink. لأن الجمل يا إخوة, you know the camel can stores, a camel can stay without water for 15 days and more. Why? Let him, don't come near him. Let him be lost. And normally the other animals are afraid of camels. الجمل يخيف, not like a sheep. Oh, leave it until the owner finds it. Oh. Why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم became upset? Because هذا الصحابي ولا say, can I grab it too? لا, it's different case here. لأن الأصل, look at this, the basic rule, الأصل في مال الناس العصمة. The basic rule regarding your wealth, it's protected. لا يحل لامرئ أن يأخذ مال مسلم إلا بطيب نفس. حتى الصدقة, it is not lawful for you to take the wealth of somebody but him giving it to you willingly. Even الصدقة, even الصدقة. وإياك وكرائم أموالهم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم tells معاذ بن جبل when he sent him to Yemen, listen, you're entitled to take the 2.5% زكاة المال, that's it. Don't take any more. Don't try to take any extra from them. وإياك وكرائم أموالهم. ليه؟ لأن الأصل في المال العصمة. And this is why, يا إخوة, you need to understand, that's why cutting the hand once it comes to this. والسارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أيديهما جزاء بما كسبا نكالا من الله. طبعا العقل. Come on. We cannot function without it. The intellect. You see, what distinguishes us from the animals? Wheels. لا يعني اللي هو العقل, the brain يعني, intelligence, intellect, rational, right? You see, animals have a system built in. They are already built-in system which they do not lose. الفطرة, governed by their فطرة, by that system. Now we are above them because of what? Of the brain. Now if we lose this, we are worse than the animals. Because we don't have that built in what? في الحيوان له قانون. يعني أنا أعجب والله يا إخوة. I told you about the donkey story. I remember, you know, sometimes you need that donkey. Sometimes we come across in the countryside, across streams, running streams, and they are normally deep and wild. And you want the donkey to jump. Wallahi, ikhwa, the donkey takes a look like this. And he backs off. Insa. عارفين الفيل بتاع الابراهة? You face it this way, it doesn't go. You face it this way, it runs. نفس الكلام. Ins. Nothing you can do about it. Beat him up to jump, he will not jump. And other cases, he would look. لأنه عارف. طب البني آدم لا شفت واحد شفت human being who's drunk. Get a human drunk human being. Huh? Can you jump this thing? Sure. He lost. ولي هذا الرجل جاء للإمام مالك يقول له I divorced my wife. He saw somebody drunk, and you know what he's trying to do? He's going up the hill and he's trying to catch the moon. He's drunk. He's trying to catch the moon. فالرجل لما شاف هذا المنظر, when he saw that scene, he said, امرأتي طالق مني. I divorced my wife. If there is a sin in Islam greater than drinking. That this is the greatest. ولذلك في القول اللي هي أم الإيه؟ أم الخبائث. The mother of all evil. الخمر. Because when you lose that, خلاص. It's over. يعني it's very unfortunate here in Colorado. وطبعا يقاس على الخمر يا إخوة anything else. كل مفتر, كل مخدر, كل مسكر. Anything that caused that intoxication, that caused that, that would include marijuana, include any type of thing that you... فحفظ العقل. Why? Why in the world you flog people 80 times على القول الجمهور يعني when they drink? Why? Because of this. Add to this, you end up harming others when you lose your intellect. يعني listen, if you go inside your room and you get drunk 24/7 and you don't come out, nobody's going to harm you. We're not supposed to go and investigate the homes whether you drink or not. لا. You see, the problem with drinking is it brings harm. Brings harm upon, huh? How many accidents are caused because of drunk driving? How many? والله my I don't know if I should call him the in Kansas City, a young boy 18 years old, the son of my wife's sister, four people in the car he was driving, four people killed. He was drunk, he was driving, 18 years old, 18, 17 years, four people. One time, just like that, just a couple of months ago, he ended up killing four people. Why? Because of what? Intellect. Oh. rational mind. That is why our Sharia stands firm, because you bring harm upon others. The last one, which inshallah we will now make it the subject of, which is hifz, the protection of progeny. Is Shuruq is here or not yet?
Yes.
Is here? Ashraqat? So we still have time before the salah or now?
10 minutes.
Oh, 10 minutes. Can we do 10 minutes? طيب, we do 10 minutes. The last of them is hifzu al-ard. You need to understand this. And this is wallahi a lot, if you can explain this to, because this is an area of confusion amongst a lot of Muslims, a lot of non-Muslims. Islam is tuned to protect the family. And anything that threatens the Muslim family, because the family is the first brick in the society, in the Muslim community. The family is the first brick. لَبِنَ الْأُولِ. Because what is a community? The community is made of what? Families. حتى يجي يقول لك, how many families are living around Colorado Muslim society? They don't say how many Muslims. They say how many what? Families. Imagine these families, the life there is not straight, is corrupt. The community is going to be what? Corrupt. But if they are straight, the community will be what? Straight. Now, what is the thing which places the first two members of the family together? What? Who are the first two members of the family? Before you have children, you should have what? Husband and father, and wife together. What is the thing which puts them together? We call it what? Marriage. What threatens marriage? Why do we get married? Beside, mashallah, having righteous children, beside. Why? Because of what? Ya ma'ashar al-shabab, man istata'a minkum al-ba'a, falyatazawaj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to guarantee the continuous production of human beings, He placed inside us the sexual desire, which we all have. And it is the strongest. The strongest. Why? Because you need that. You need to fulfill it. How are you going to fulfill it? Now Islam tells you the only way to fulfill it is to go find a wife. Others, they tell you adultery. That is why flog the adulterers. Stop that adultery. Because that adultery is a threat to what? You understand, ya ikhwa? It's a threat. Why people are not getting married now? Why? Why the marriage rate is, and the divorce rate is? Why? Tell me. Somebody tells you, listen, if I can fulfill it, why do I need to go take a wife? And they tell you, I can actually do 3 years and then recycle and go find another one. والثقافة ماشية كده. يقول لك طب ما انا اقعد لي مع دي سنتين وبعدين راح اخذ واحدة ثانية. طبعا هو لا يقيس المقاييس بمقاييس الشرع, هو رجل يعني desire. فإسلام tells you no, stop this adultery. That is why the punishment is severe. And stop anything that leads to it too. And this is what Surah An-Nur is all about. Ya ikhwa, when we talk about mixing between the genders, mixing is not haram in itself. No, it is not. But you see, mixing is dari'a lizina, leads to adultery. Block it. Like we did with shirk. The same thing. Block anything that leads to shirk. Block anything that leads to adultery. Lowering the gaze, for example. غض البصر. It is not haram in itself, for your information. It is not. المغيرة بن شعبة came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال رسول الله كما عند النساء, I proposed to a woman from Al-Ansar. I asked a woman to marry. Look, the Prophet ﷺ said to him, هل نظرت إليها? Did you look at her? Go look at her. Is she his wife? Is she his wife? She's not his wife. Yet the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Quran, قل للمؤمنين يغضوا, tell the believers to lower their gaze. Yet he's telling him to go out and look. Why? Because this is another case here. But why lowering the gaze is haram in Islam if you don't have a reason to? Because, like we say, everything begins with what? Nadra, a look, then a smile, then a text message, then a phone call. هو الموضوع على فكرة مش not يعني no one in the world, I have never heard somebody, unless they are wicked people, that you look at somebody and you go commit adultery. طب شوف الربط, شوف الربط. قل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم وإيه, شوف الربط, ويحفظوا فروجهم. Tell the believing men to lower their gaze and to protect themselves from committing adultery. But there is a process between those two. But you can't stop it. The easiest way to stop it is if you lower your gaze. Why? Because if you look, you desire. Yeah, the heart desires. And when you desire, you start what, thinking of ways to fulfill it. How can I see her? Where does she go? But if you lower, you did not see her completely. خلاص, خلص الموضوع. The easiest thing that you can do. أسهل شيء في العملية. The more you progress, the more difficult it becomes. يا أيها, ولذلك يقول لك إيه؟ يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Steps of شيطان. Step after step after step. ولذلك تجد النصوص في الزنا, ولا تقربوا, do not come near it. طبعا الشيطان يجي يقول لك تعالى ومش عارف. Again, I want to take you to the higher goal here, which is the protection of the family, the institution of the family. Also add to this, this child has the right to be born to a father and mother, not to a girlfriend and a boyfriend. One of the brothers yesterday told me that he has two women living together in his neighbors. And this is my wife, this is my husband. Two women. And guess, here is the painful piece, they have a son. A son, how did this happen? I mean, they have a son, two women have a son. And mommy, one of them is mommy and the other one is daddy. Oh, but then the brother is asking me, sometimes the daddy, yani, who is the daddy, when I pick up my child to take him to school with, goes, لا تفعل, don't do it. When I give my son a ride, yani, don't do it. You're going to mix up the system of your son. How in the world would you do that to a child? That's haram. This is unfair. This is unfair. This is the top of the line of injustice. A child has the right to be born to a father and a mother, living together, committed to the relationship. Not a boyfriend, not a girlfriend. Sometimes they don't even... We need to look into the punishment which is mentioned at the beginning of Surah An-Nur in light of this, the protection of the family. Add to this in closing, so we can, sometimes individual, and this is the best way to explain the issue of hijab to a non-Muslim. Because they look at the hijab being a sign of inequality on the side of women, yeah. The best way to explain this, listen, sometimes, and memorize that statement, and it's not mine, I actually took it from somebody else. Sometimes individual liberties are sacrificed for the greater goal. Personal liberties, freedom, is sacrificed for the society. What do you mean? You don't want women to become an icon of temptation in the society. Because this is also one of the things that leads to adultery. Women going out in a fashion that invites temptation. We're going to sacrifice your freedom. You're going to be covered to protect this from happening. And on and on. فإن شاء الله بإذن الله تعالى, this was a little introduction to Surah An-Nur. We begin with the first verses بإذن الله تعالى next Saturday. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله رب العالمين.